The New Bedford Highway Killer is an unidentified serial killer responsible for the deaths of at least 9 women and the disappearances of 2 additional women in New Bedford, Massachusetts, between March 1988 and April 1989. The killer is also suspected to have assaulted numerous other women. All the killer's victims were known sex workers or had struggles with addiction. While the victims were taken from New Bedford, they were all found in different surrounding towns, including Dartmouth, Freetown, and Westport, Massachusetts, along Route 140. The main detective that pursued the case was John Dexterler. Victims: Robin Rhodes, 28, last seen in New Bedford, March-April 1988. Body found March 28, 1989, along Route 140. Rochelle Clifford Dopier Ally, 28, last seen in New Bedford, late April 1988. Body found December 10, 1988, along Reed Road, 2 miles from Interstate 195. Deborah Lynn McConnell, 25, last seen in New Bedford, May 1988. Body found December 1, 1988, off Route 140. Deborah Medeiros, 30, last seen in New Bedford, May 27, 1988. Body found July 3, 1988, on Route 140. Christine Montero, 19, last seen in New Bedford, late May 1988. Marilyn Roberts, 34, last seen in New Bedford, June 1988. Nancy Pava, 36, last seen in New Bedford, July 7, 1988. Body found July 30, 1988. Alongside Interstate 195. Deborah DeMello, 35, last seen in New Bedford, July 11, 1988. Body found November 8, 1988, alongside Interstate 195. Mary Rose Santos, 26, last seen in New Bedford, July 16, 1988. Body found March 31, 1989, along Route 88. Sandra Botelho, 24, last seen in New Bedford, August 11, 1988. Body found April 24, 1989, along Interstate 195. Dawn Mendez, 25, last seen in New Bedford, September 4, 1988. Body found November 29, 1988, alongside Interstate 195. Suspects: Anthony DeGrazia. May 1989, Anthony DeGrazia was identified by a locally known New Bedford sex worker by means of a picture provided by a young, inexperienced detective, Lorraine Forrest. The sex worker, who described the assailant as having a flat nose, never named DeGrazia as a positive suspect, but stated that he looked like the man who assaulted her. Anthony DeGrazia was later accused of 17 rapes and assaults on several sex workers. Based on allegations, DeGrazia was questioned, arrested, and charged with the 17 rapes and assaults, while also being investigated as a suspect in the 9 murders along area highways. After 15 months of incarceration and 18 court appearances, DeGrazia was released on bail in January 1990. He was then briefly rearrested for allegedly uttering threats to the DA Ronald Pinna for wrongful prosecution and imprisonment. DeGrazia again posted bond, but was then later found dead at his girlfriend's house, under a picnic table. His death was ruled a suicide. Authorities investigated his possible connection to the New Bedford murders. Kenneth C. Punt. In August 1990, a grand jury indicted New Bedford attorney Kenneth Punt, 40, in the murder of Rochelle Clifford Dopier Ally, who had been beaten to death. Punt had a checkered past, including drug use and a prior incident involving Dopier Ally. Bristol County District Attorney Ronald Pinna suggested that Punt had murdered Dopier Ally because she was allegedly planning to expose his drug activities. Dopier Ally's mother stated that her daughter had once given her telephone number to Punt in the event she needed to be reached. Punt admitted to having represented Dopier Ally in April 1988, shortly before she disappeared, when she accused another man of raping her. Punt moved to Port Richey, Florida, in September 1988. He was arraigned on a single count of murder on August 17, 1990. Pond entered a plea of absolutely not guilty and posted a $50,000 bond. On July 29, 1991, the district attorney dropped murder charges against Pond, citing lack of evidence. The following year, remaining drug and assault charges were dropped and the New Bedford case went cold. Pond resurfaced in the news in May 2009 in two separate incidents. Police dug up the driveway and patio of Pond's former New Bedford home with a backhoe, but were unable to find evidence linking Pond to any crime. On the morning of May 15, Pond was arrested for shoplifting and was found with four cans of sardines and a block of cheese stolen from a Price Right store in New Bedford. On January 27, 2010, Pond was found dead in his New Bedford home. The Bristol County District Attorney's Office has discounted foul play as a cause of death. Daniel Tavares Jr. While in prison for the murder of his mother, Daniel Thomas Tavares Jr. sent a threatening letter to one of the prison staff indirectly claiming responsibility for the highway killings. He lived in New Bedford, and had knowledge of where another murdered woman, Gail Botelho, had been buried, within a mile from his home. He was convicted of two recent killings, those of Brian and Bev Muak. Additionally, he was convicted in 2015 of the murder of Gail Botelho, who went missing in 1988, later found to have been under a tree in his backyard. Lisbon Ripper. Between 1992 and 1993, three sex workers were slain and disemboweled with an instrument that was not a knife in Lisbon, Portugal, by an unknown serial killer that was dubbed the Lisbon Ripper, while two further sex workers were shot dead on the opposite shore of the Tagus River in the same time period. In March 1993, two detectives of the Portuguese Polícia Judiciária traveled to New Bedford to gather information on the highway killings, while two agents of the FBI traveled to Lisbon, following the hypothesis that the string of crimes on both sides of the Atlantic could have been committed by the same individual. New Bedford has a sizable Portuguese community and many of the highway victims were of Portuguese ancestry. The Lisbon murders were also linked to four similar killings that took place in Belgium, the Netherlands, Denmark and the Czech Republic, all countries bordering Germany between 1993 and 1997, the theory being that the Lisbon Ripper had then become a long-haul truck driver. In 2011, a 21-year-old man named Joel applied to participate in the Portuguese edition of the reality show Secret Story, where participants try to guess each other's secrets while concealing their own. The secret he applied with was that his father, José Pedro Guedes, was the Lisbon Ripper. Guedes, 46, was arrested and confessed to the three slayings, but could not be prosecuted because murder has a prescription period of 15 years in Portugal and the last murders had ended in 2008. Guedes could still be prosecuted for the 2000 murder of a prostitute in Aveiro, Portugal and similar murders in Germany, or neighboring countries where Guedes resided in the 1990s. It is unknown, however, if Guedes ever resided in the United States. Guedes was tried for the Aveiro murder in 2013, found not proven due to lack of evidence, and released. The sentence noted that several details given by Guedes about the Aveiro and Lisbon murders were inaccurate. See also list of serial killers in the United States. References.